Hi guys and welcome back to the channel. Now I know I haven't been uploading much recently, but I have actually been busy and I've been filming it and I just got to get around to editing it, so hopefully you'll have a number of videos coming up soon. Been working on both the Volvo and on the S4, which is behind me there. Today we are going to be working on the brakes of the Volvo, and what we're going to be fitting is a pair of these are Brembo four pot calipers from an Alfa Romeo 166. Now they don't normally fit directly onto these, so I've got some brackets made, so thank you very much. Firstly, a guy called Bart, who is on the Volvo S40 V40 Facebook group, he will be able to sell you these brackets because I think he has now got a few of these made. But I'd like to thank him because he sent me the CAD file to get these made, and then secondly to Mr. Luke Rainbird, who took the file and converted it into something that someone could use, and he also printed it out on his 3D printer so I could test to make sure it fitted first. And thirdly, I uploaded a picture of the brackets, you'll probably see it here somewhere, and Kieran Simpson reached out to me and he actually got these manufactured and they are brilliant. So these are made from aluminium in 6082 and then he got them anodized in black and they look marvelous, and I have tested and they do fit perfectly. So that's what we're going to be doing today. You'll probably see there are no struts on the car at the moment. I've just been doing a few little things. I've had to repair a CV, I've had to change the tie rod ends, one of the inner tie rods had some movement in it as well, and I've also had to, up here in preparation, I've had to make a new brake line there because this fitting here was completely rounded. So what we're going to do is I'm going to chuck the struts on first and then fit the brakes. So here we are, I've got the driver's side strut on. So this bracket goes on the inside with the bolts coming through this way. So I've got a couple of 12.9 cap head, nice zinc coated ones, and I'm going to drop a little bit of thread lock on there. Now that they're in there, we've got to make sure that we torque these up properly. So now that we've got the bracket on, we can put the disc on, and this disc is actually from a Mercedes and they have a 5x112 PCD, and this is a 4x114.3, so I've had to drill this out to match the PCD. I will show you in a moment how I've done that, but I'll get this on for now. I'm going to give that a quick wipe with some acetone, get all the greasy marks off of it, and then the caliper, as I said, sits in front of that bracket. And the bolts get fed in from behind. So this is our new disc, it's actually from a Mercedes, so the PCD is 5x112, and we need to make this the same PCD as the Volvo, which is 4x114.3. So if I grab the other disc, so this is the old disc and you'll notice that it's got a load of holes in it already. So like I mentioned before, this was originally from a Legnum or a Glant, and they are 5x114, so I've had to redrill the PCD to match the car on these already. The way that I do this is, or the way that I have done this, so I flip this over so they are face to face and I rotate this round. The center bore is the same, although when you line these up you can see that it's slightly tighter on the Mercedes disc than this, but they are supposed to be the same PCD. So I line them up so all these five holes line up. They're not exactly right, so you can see there, that is the difference between the 114 and 112. So I have made something to make sure that this center bore is kept constant, and it is this. So it's basically a hockey puck which I had lying around, and I turned it on the lathe so it is the right size and it just kind of fits in there snugly. And then I crank that bolt up, expands the puck and holds it nice and tight. So I'll just get the impact gun on that. So there we are, that is nice and tight on there now. Just to make it extra secure, I'm going to stick a nut and bolt in a couple of these, so then I can drill these ones out. So this one here is a shared hole, so that one has to get drilled out as well, which is not great because it's a bit of an interference cut. It's only cutting on one side when you send a drill through there, but if you have the drill going nice and fast, it shouldn't hang up on that edge, and hopefully will be okay. Well, it worked for the last one, so it should work again. So there we go, all holes are drilled out. I'm just going to unbolt this, clean up the holes and throw it on the car. So there we go, managed to get this side bolted onto the car last night. And we are ready to bleed. So I've got some brake fluid there and this side is ready to go, and all I need is my glamorous assistant, who is unknowingly in the kitchen. So I'm going to get her, and no pressure bleed here. All we're going to do is do it the old-fashioned way. She'll press the pedal and I'm going to let the pressure out of the bleed nipples. So it should only take a couple of minutes, hopefully, and everything will be working again. Down. Down. Up. Down. So, the other night I managed to get the brakes bled, by which time it was too late to do anything and I think it started raining. So today was the first opportunity to take it for a little drive just up the driveway, and there was quite a lot of binding and I thought it was just the pads kind of bedding in, but it just seemed a little bit, well, quite a lot worse than that. So I have whipped the brakes off, and I don't know how this didn't show up before when I fitted them to the test hubs and I fitted them to the spare S40 that I had whilst it was still in the yard. Basically, the offset was wrong and the caliper has been binding on the disc. So if I spin this round, you can see this mark here, which has been pretty badly galled up by something, and there's quite a few score marks in here, and everything was covered. You can see just here, I've actually wiped this off, but a lot of iron filings. So essentially the caliper was too far across this way on the disc, so this is essentially slightly too thick. What I've done for now, and this is only to quickly test to make sure I am right, is I've put a little spacer in between the hub and the bracket. So that brings the caliper slightly inboard a little bit, and that should fix the issue. So I'm going to bolt this all up, put the disc back on, see how the disc sits inside the caliper, do the other side, make sure it works, take it for a quick test drive just up and down the driveway, and then what I'll do is I'll whip these off and get these shaved down so they fit properly. Okay, I've managed to speak to Bart about this, and he's done a few of these now. On his own car, they bolted up absolutely fine, and there was no issues with the alignment of the caliper to the disc. But on some other cars, he's noticed that these mounts have actually been bent, so they're not true with the hub face. So they're actually, they bend inwards. So we are not entirely sure why, whether it's because these cars were originally fitted with single pot sliders, and if they're used hard that might cause a bit of twist to them. I've already done the other side. All I've got to do on this side is just calibrate these so they are square with this face with a precision instrument. That will only take a second or two. Okay, so there we have it. The disc is now firmly in the center of that caliper. Top and bottom, you can't really see at the top, but it is. And yeah, it took a few attempts, a little bit annoying because you've got to take everything off to make the tabs available, get them into place and then put it all back together, and then you can check. You don't want to go too far and obviously you've got the offset issue then. So that is all done. Just got to throw the pads in, put the wheel on, and it is job done. So finally, the brakes are done. Got the Brembos on there, and they appear to be working quite well. Just need to bed the pads in, of course. So that is it for this video. Thank you to Bart for all his help. Thank you to Kieran for CNCing the brackets, and thank you to Luke for printing them out in 3D for me so I could test to make sure they fitted, even though they didn't. If you've enjoyed this video, please hit the like button, subscribe if you haven't done so. If you've got any questions, drop in the comments below, and I will see you in the next one. Cheers.